So, good morning, students. So, last class we have discussed about how to measure air temperature, and there were different thermometers that we have discussed, and how to measure, how to record, and when to record. Those things we have discussed. So, in this class also, it is about the thermometers, but not about the air temperature thermometers. It is about the soil temperature thermometers actually. So, how to measure the soil temperature, and which thermometer we'll be using, and how to install it, and when to measure it. So these things we'll be discussing in today's class. Okay, let's start the class. So installation of soil thermometers and measurement of soil temperature. So we'll discuss one by one. So first of all, you should know the importance of soil temperature, why we should measure the soil temperature. As we know that last class we have discussed about the air temperature. It is one of the most important micrometeorological parameter that will be influencing your growth and development from sowing to harvesting. Same way, soil temperature is also most important micrometeorological parameter that also will be influencing your crop from your sowing to harvesting. Each stage will be influenced by your soil temperature, because you know that everything will be coming to the crop from soil only, like right from your water to minerals, nutrients, everything will be coming from your soil only. So it is most important parameter, soil temperature. So as we have said already, it affects crop growth starting from seed germination to harvesting actually. So if the temperature is beyond a certain limit or below the certain limit, all your process will be stopped actually. It will not be, your crop will not be able to take up the nutrients from the soil, and at the same time during sowing and all, your soil temperature should be optimum, then only your crop will start germinating. So it is most important from germination to harvesting actually. So every process will be influenced by soil temperature. So apart from that, it also influences your microbial activity in the soil actually. You know that there are so many microorganisms present in the soil, like fungus, bacteria, or virus. Many microbial organisms are present in the soil, and your soil temperature can influence a lot the activity of activity of microbes actually. You know that these activities are very much important for your crop, means mineralization or many processes conversion of inorganic to organic, organic to inorganic. Everything will be happening because of your microbes actually. So this activity will be influenced by your soil temperature, and uptake of mineralization of nutrients actually. Uptake and mineralization of nutrients. So you know that when the temperature is not favorable for the crop, when the soil temperature is too much high or too below, it will be influencing your root activity actually. So once your root is affected, automatically your uptake will be affected. And second thing is mineralization. Hope you know what you mean by mineralization actually. It is the conversion of inorganic to organic nutrients. So mineralization also will be affected by your soil temperature. Every process will be having its own optimum temperature actually. So when it is going beyond or below that limit, automatically those processes will be stopped or it will be affected. And organic matter and soil texture also will be influenced by your soil temperature. This weathering and everything will be influencing your soil texture. So once your temperature is changing, or if it is not favorable, your weathering may be affected, or it may be stopped. Or if the weathering is not happening, automatically your soil texture will be changing. Or if it is weathering happening also, your soil texture will be changing actually in the long run. And organic matter, that also will be influenced by your soil temperature. Means more temperature will be leading to more weathering or more decomposition. So that way your organic matter will be more. At the same time, if it is beyond certain limit, your activity, microbial activity may be decreased, and at the same time your organic matter content also will be decreased. So this is the soil thermometer that we will be using it in our observatory. Soil mercury in glass thermometer actually. And this is just an effect of temperature and root development actually. This is potato crop actually, you can see here. So the optimum temperature is around 20 degrees Celsius. So when it is going beyond 20 degrees Celsius and below 20 degrees Celsius, automatically your root development will be affected. So soil temperature is most important for your crop growth and development from germination to harvesting. Then how to measure it? So last class itself we have discussed so many thermometers actually based on the different based on its mechanisms. There were different thermometers we have listed out. Here we are using only three thermometers like mercury in glass thermometer, resistance thermometer, thermocouple. So last class itself we have discussed each one. What do you mean by mercury thermometer? What do you mean by resistance thermometer and thermocouple? Hope you have studied it actually. So this is an example part of soil thermometer actually. So here at different depths we will be using, we will be measuring the soil thermometer that we will be dealing in this slide actually. Here you can see for agricultural purposes if you want to record soil temperature at least at minimum two depths you should record actually. So at least at two depth. More than that also you can record, but minimum at two levels you should have soil temperature readings for your agricultural crops actually. So more than that also you can have, that is up to you. If you have more thermometers, you can fix it at more depth actually. And whatever the depth if you want to study, that will be decided by the micrometeorologist actually. So if you want to conduct an experiment, you will be deciding at what depths you want to record the soil temperature or soil temperature readings. So depth will be decided by the micrometeorologist or the concerned scientist. They will be deciding based on their research interest actually, what they are going to look into, whether they are going to study about the microbes or whether they are going to study about the rooting pattern or whether they are going to study about the nutrient uptake. So based on their interest, depth will be varying actually. So generally WMO recommends these depths actually, 10 centimeter, 20 centimeter, 50 and 100 centimeter. These four depths WMO recommends actually. This is not limited to this depth actually. If you feel that 5 centimeter is important, you can keep your soil thermometer at 5 centimeter also. And if you feel that 100 centimeters important or 150 centimeters important, there also you can keep the soil thermometer and you can record your soil temperature reading. And in IMD, they recommend soil temperature readings at different depth like 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 60, 100 and 150 centimeters actually. So that is mainly based on your interest. You need not record this many soil temperature at these many depths. But whatever your importance, say if you are growing a rice crop, that you will not be recording soil temperature of 150 centimeters actually, because your roots will not be reaching. Very rare cases it may reach, but the most common plants it will not be reaching to 150 centimeters. And say if you are going for some perennial crops, that time and all you need to record soil temperature from deeper depth actually. That time and all you can go for 150 centimeters and all, that will be useful for you. So these are recommendations actually. You need not take it up completely. Based on your requirement, you can fix your soil temperature depth actually. At which depth you want to measure, you can do it actually. So then the one thing is that we'll be using two terms while you speak about soil thermometers actually. One is soil thermometer, second one is earth thermometer actually. So if a thermometer which is used to record temperature of more than 30 centimeter depth, it will be called as earth thermometer actually. So up to 30 centimeter depth, you will be calling it as a soil thermometer, and once it goes beyond 30 centimeter, it will be called as earth thermometer. Say if a thermometer is used at 60 centimeter depth, then it will be called as earth thermometer. So that's all, soil thermometer and earth thermometer. So how to operate and how to measure. So before that, you should see the soil thermometer first. So this is what soil thermometer actually, it will be looking like. Your scales will be there here, and in between glass bore will be there, in this mercury content will be there, and the outer vessel will be there actually, glass vessel will be there, that will be protecting your inside, means bore of the thermometer actually, fused bore will be there, that will be protected by this outside wall, and an iron stand will be there to support the thermometer. And this is the bulb of the thermometer. At desirable depth, this bulb will be kept, and after that installation will be done. So this we will discuss. It is same as that of mercury in glass thermometers that we have discussed in the last class actually. We have discussed about maximum thermometer. So it is also the same kind of thermometer only. Thing is that there will be, it will be having too much length actually, because at different depth we have to install now. So based on that, your length of the thermometer also will be varying. So only thing is vessel is an extra part here. See, this is what vessel. Outside protective cover is there, no? That is glass cover that will be protecting your inside bore actually. So this is what vessel. So and apart from that, there will be bend in your bulb, near the bulb. In the top of the bulb, there will be bend of 120 degrees. So that if you fix the thermometer, that if you fix the bulb horizontally to the earth, there will be your thermometer will be in slanting position actually. In such a way, it will be there. 120 degree bend will be there actually. So this is to make the observation easier. That we will be discussing later why it is. And your iron stand will be of 60 degree angle. Your iron stand will be of 60 degree angle. This angle will be 60 degree angle. So to support your soil thermometer, so it will not be falling below your soil thermometer. And the immersion depth, at which depth you are going to immerse, that will be mainly based on your length of the depth you are going to use. Say from bulb to up to this height, you can immerse in soil actually. So this is the immersion depth actually. Up to here, you can immerse your thermometer into the soil. This is ground level, here will be, and this part will be underground. So that's what. And this length will be varying between the thermometers actually. If it is 5 cm, this length will be 6.5 cm. And if it is 15 cm or 30 cm, based on that, this length will be varying actually. So that much length it will be going inside the soil. And outside, this part will be almost similar with all the thermometers. Only this length will be varying with a different depth. And so as we have discussed earlier, the graduation begins at 6.5 centimeter. That is, from here to here, 6.5 centimeter will be there. From here, the graduation will be beginning actually. So that's what, for 5 centimeter depth. And for 15 centimeter depth, it will be beginning at 17.5 centimeter. And for 30 centimeter depth, it will be beginning at 35 centimeter. So with variation in the depth, length of this this part also will be varying actually. So that is most important. And so you know that it is a plot, it is not a single thermometer. You will be recording it in different depth, maybe at 5 cm, 10 cm, 15 cm. You will be selecting a plot, there you will be installing all this thermometer. At 5 cm, you will be installing one thermometer, 10 another, 15 another, 30 another, 60 another, 100, 150, like that you will be going and installing actually. So you can install many thermometers, whatever you want, maybe 5 or 10 thermometers you can install. But between thermometers, you should maintain some space actually. That is, 45 centimeters should be there between thermometers. Between each thermometer, there should be 45 centimeter distance should be there. So then only your readings will be perfect, and your thermometers also will not be, physical damages also will not be happening to your thermometer. And next important thing is your scale portion. Say this reading portion is there, no? It should be facing towards south, and whereas inclination is towards north. So this is with respect to northern hemisphere. In southern hemisphere, it will be opposite. So scale portion should be towards north. It should be facing towards north, whereas your inclination should be towards north. Facing should be towards south. Inclination should be towards north. So that is to avoid its own shade actually. So hope you know what I meant actually. So in the initial classes and all, we said that tallest instrument should be kept in northern hemisphere, in north side of the observatory actually. So in order to avoid the shade actually, so that your shade will be falling outside the observatory. Same way here also, we are saying that the facing should be towards south. So in order to avoid the shading of its own thermometer, you say if it is towards south side, when the temperature is there, this own shade will be falling on this bulb actually. So automatically your readings will be affected. So if the bulb area is covered by shade, then it will not be, direct radiation will be falling on that. Automatically conduction will be less and temperature will be less, and that will not be the original reading actually. So your readings will be affected. So in order to avoid that, your thermometer should face, your scale of the thermometer should face south in northern hemisphere, and you should be inclined towards north. So scale should face south, so that you should take care of it actually. Otherwise your own shade will be falling on its own bulb and your readings will be affected. The measurement plot what you are fixing, you will be having many thermometers to measure. The plot to install many thermometers, you might have selected a plot. No, that plot should be free from weeds actually. It should be an empty plot where only soil should be there actually. And your reading should be taken at 7 hours and 14 hours LMT. You should calculate LMT to your own timing, keeping IST at 7 and 14. So that time you should measure your soil temperature. So this is how soil temperature readings are taken actually. So this is what we have discussed, soil temperature. A bend will be there. This is what bulb actually, at desired depth, this bulb will be kept horizontally. And if you keep it horizontally, there will be 120 degree angle with the bulb and this portion actually. There will be 120 degree angle will be there. And to give support, there will be iron stand will be there that will be having 60 degree angle, so that it will be fixed permanently, fixed perfectly in the soil actually. So I said 120 degree. Now why we are keeping it for 120 degree? Because so it is in the soil level, at ground level, maybe from ground to 30 centimeter height it may be. If you want to read it actually, if it is straight like this, if you don't you assume that this angle is not there, and your soil thermometer is like this, it like this. Say I'll just try applying. If your soil thermometer is having say without any bend, if it is a straight line, say it will be and this is your bulb, and this is your thermometer portion, and this is your bulb portion. Assume that there is no bend, it is 90 degree angle, it is without any bend they have kept. And this is your bulb portion, it will be lying in the soil, this is your portion. We have to measure the temperature now. How will you measure? If you are sitting also, you will not be able to see the graduation section. It will be very difficult to read the graduation actually. So that will be very difficult to take the measurement. What can you do is actually you can lie on the ground and you can look at the readings actually. That will be a very tedious process actually. So to make it simple only, we are giving this 120 degree angle actually. So that your say, by sitting here, you can just look at these scales and you can measure it easily. Whereas if it is straight, means it will be very difficult to read. To make it convenient only, they have given 120 degree angle to measure your thermometer perfectly, soil temperature reading perfectly. So that is what about your soil temperature. And I said there will be different depth, different thermometers will be there. And same thermometer cannot be used for a different depth. For different depth, different thermometers will be using. Because I said this length will be varying with the depth. 5 centimeter level means this length will be around 6.5 or 7 centimeter. Whereas if you want to record at 30 centimeter means this length will be around 35 centimeter. So for each depth, that specific thermometer should be used. You cannot use the same thermometer for all the depth. That also you should remember it actually. So that is what about your soil temperature measurement. The last part is soil temperature dynamics. So we said we different depth will be measuring the soil temperature, and how the temperature varies with time with different depth. That is also important. See here, if you see it here, 1 centimeter is there, 5 centimeter is there, 20 centimeter is there, and 80 centimeter is there. At different depth, they have recorded the soil temperature and they have plotted this graph actually. Say if you see here, 1 centimeter, you see here it is midnight 12 o'clock. And it will be decreasing. Maybe at 5 o'clock or something, up to that the temperature will be, lowest temperature will be reaching at that time. And after that sunrise will be there, the temperature will be started increasing. It will be reaching peak by 12 o'clock or 1 o'clock. And again it will be declining. And at 12 o'clock it will be coming to the same level actually. This is with respect to 1 centimeter. That means at surface level. So surface level, you know that first your radiation will be hitting the surface, after that only it will be moving into the deeper depths actually. So first the surface will be heated up, so automatically the heat or the temperature of the surface will be higher than any other depth actually. That also you should remember. And then comes the 5 centimeter depth. See, 5 centimeter depth, even though during daytime it is lesser, if you look at night time, see here it is a little bit higher than your 1 centimeter depth. See here, 1 centimeter depth is here, and whereas night temperature is little bit higher. It is because that during the night time, you know that during the daytime you will be receiving the radiation, so automatically your surface will be higher. This will be passing the radiation through conduction, and this will be heating up the 5 centimeter. So there will be some time lag will be there between 1 centimeter and 5 centimeter, and it will be taking, this will be exposed to direct radiation, this will not be exposed to direct radiation. So that effect also will be there. So because of that, your temperature will be little lesser. And whereas if you compare during night time, daytime it is okay, 5 centimeter will be lesser. but during night time it will be little bit higher than your surface level, because say daytime heating will be happening, night time cooling will be happening actually. So when cooling happens, what happens is actually your surface depth will be losing its temperature very faster actually. All the particles which is lying on the surface will be re-radiating the radiation to the atmosphere. Automatically it will lose its energy and the temperature will be lesser. Whereas 5 centimeter, it will be taking some time actually, because it will be compared to the surface, subsurface will be more heated during your night time. Automatically the temperature will be higher. Same way for your 20 centimeter also. And when you look at 80 centimeter, there won't be any difference actually. There won't be any diurnal variation, because your daytime heating also, it will not be reaching that level, and nighttime cooling also, it will be similar actually. When it is not heated up, it will be remaining at the same level actually. It has nothing to lose actually. So at 80 centimeter, the temperature will be almost constant throughout the day. That means night and day will be similar actually. There won't be any difference, because during the daytime, your radiation will not be reaching to that level to heat up the layer actually, that particular layer. So automatically your temperature at 80 centimeter or at deeper depths will be remaining constant. There won't be any difference. There won't be any diurnal variation. So this is with respect to this class soil temperature, how to install, how to measure, and what are their importance that we have discussed. And these are your assignment part actually, that I will be uploading it in Moodle also. You can see the questions there. Why the bulb of the soil temperature is bent, that we have asked. We said there is a 120 degree angle above the bulb. Why it is so? Why that 120 degrees needed? 120 degrees needed. That you should answer. And one more thing is, I said the scale of the soil thermometer should be facing some direction. Why it is to face that direction, and what is the reason behind that? So that you should write. And third important question is, write down the importance of soil temperature and nutrient uptake. So how soil temperature is playing a role in nutrient uptake. So you should write about these questions in your assignment, and I'll create a link in Moodle so that you can upload it. And I hope it is clear, and if there is any clarifications, you can write to me in Moodle. We can discuss it. I can solve them in there, and I'll create a link also. You can upload your assignment there. Okay, thank you.